It's been a record-breaking year of bills proposed in state legislatures that would limit transgender rights, from access to medical care to sports participation. Despite that, a new PBS NewsHour NPR Marist poll found that Americans across the political spectrum oppose those efforts, and more than half of people personally know someone who is transgender. John Yang has our report.
Late afternoon in Boise, Idaho, and Lindsay Hecox is doing what she loves most. A track and cross-country runner in high school, Hecox, now 20 years old, dreams of running for Boise State University, where she's a student.
I don't know how I would have gotten through high school if I didn't have my running teams. They were my only friend group. I kind of just feel like I need friendship through running again.
For most teenagers, going from high school to college is a big step. But for Hecox, it was a major life change. She came out as transgender, meaning her gender identity does not align with the sex she was assigned at birth, a condition known as gender dysphoria.
Gender dysphoria just sucks. You don't get to be the person you were meant to be just because of some random luck when you were born. I'm able to deal with struggles in life a lot better now just because I've already gotten through this.
As her transition and college began, she found herself at the center of a political firestorm.
All female athletes want is a fair shot at competition. But what if that shot was taken away by a competitor who claims to be a girl but was born a boy?
Opportunities for women are being shoved aside for a new priority, transgender athletes.
Last year, Idaho became the first state in the nation to ban transgender women and girls from competing on all female sports teams.
House Bill number 500 just passed the House.
Hecox, who had begun her transition not even a year earlier, was at the state capitol speaking out.
I think I'm rightfully pissed off that they word it so that I'm othered and made different when it doesn't need to be that way.
After Idaho's Republican governor, Brad Little, signed the measure, Hecox sued, and a federal judge blocked the law from taking effect. In the years since, three more states, Mississippi, Tennessee, and Arkansas, have enacted similar bans. It's part of a sweeping trend. More than 60 such laws proposed in nearly 30 states this year alone, according to the Human Rights Campaign, an LGBTQ advocacy group.
This seems to be yet another in the list along party lines of the kind of cultural clashes we've seen where Democrats are on one side of the fence and Republicans on the other side.
Lee Maringoff is the director of the Marist College Institute for Public Opinion.
That the Republicans are, you know, saying, all right, we're going to talk to our cultural base here, and we're not going to worry about the broader public opinion.
I'm calling from Marist College. We're talking to people in your community and collecting...
A PBS NewsHour NPR Marist poll released today found Americans split on whether transgender athletes should be allowed to play on high school teams. But among Republicans, an overwhelming majority said they should not. However, when asked whether they should be banned by law, a large majority of both Republicans and Democrats said no.
They don't want to legislate. They don't want to go to that level of extreme views or actions in their own minds.
I'm not a politician. I'm a pediatrician.
For transgender youth and their physicians, like Robert Garofalo at Lurie Children's Hospital in Chicago, the effect of these bills could be very personal.
My understanding of legislation is that we legislate things that are problems. This is legislation in search of a problem.
The NCAA allows transgender athletes to compete on single-sex teams after a year of hormone therapy. Neither they nor state high school athletic associations keep track of the number of transgender competitors. But a recent Associated Press analysis found only a handful of instances among the hundreds of thousands of students playing high school sports. Those backing the ban say transgender females have an unfair advantage. Connecticut allowed transgender high school athletes beginning in 2017. Last year, four female track team members sued, saying that just two transgender runners had won titles that had been held by nine different female athletes.
I was forced to compete against biological males. Girls across Connecticut and New England all knew the outcome of our races long before the start, and it was extremely demoralizing.
Most medical experts, including the American Academy of Pediatrics, say there's no scientific or medical evidence that transgender female athletes inherently have an edge.
We're not legislating sports participation based on the size of your shoe or based upon your height or other sort of immutable characteristics.
In fact, Heacock says she noticed a difference the moment she transitioned.
Minutes are now gone from what I would be able to do in a 5K. I'll feel like I can't go as longer, so stamina, my muscles will give out. I'll need to stop quicker.
Dr. Garofalo says excluding transgender youth from athletics could be devastating for them, recalling his own teen years.
Sports participation, especially in high school or junior high school, is much broader than whether you win or lose. If you would have told me when I was 17 that I couldn't play on the soccer team or I couldn't play on the tennis team, so much of my self-esteem, so much of what I pinned my self-worth as a teenager would have been erased or eradicated.
Heacock hopes that public opinion will continue to shift in favor of transgender rights as more people hear stories like hers.
Things will get better. This legislation is just a momentary setback for trans acceptance.
What would you say to your high school self?
Yeah, I would say that even though this is a hard, I don't want to just fade from the world and not have any impact on it. I'm on the leading edge of this, like, last frontier is trans people. It's really awesome. So high school self, be happy that you got this opportunity and keep fighting.
Fighting both in the courts and on the track for a slot on the team. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang.